So here's the young man from
the next competitor,
Japan. Last to go in this group.
Japan. Please welcome Takahito Mura.
Lying in 11th place. In his second Worlds, his last Worlds were 4 years ago, but he dropped out of the radar, really, because he just didn't do well enough in Japanese nationals. But here at the age of 22, he's back. A place in the top 10 would do him just fine. Takahito Mura, with music from Shogun. It's a quad toe first up for him. Here it is. Not quite. Was he round?
No, single downgrade on that. Don't think it was more than a single downgrade, though, which is important for him.
Combination. Triple Lutz. Triple toe loop. And a prodigious height on that triple axel.
Yeah, that really was magnificent.
It here, don't they, in Canada? You hear the applause raining down just for that one jump because they saw how well he performed it. Very comfortable. Triple loop, rather. And the axel this time in combination. Double toe loop on the end.
Tell you what, he should get some really good grade of execution marks from the judges for those two axels.
Double toe. Triple salco, double toe, rather. Is he going to be able to see it through to the end? It's a demanding program, this. Flip. Well, the Japanese have got what it takes. And remember, there's one more still to go, the most popular of them all, Daisuke Takahashi. But Hanyu was great, and after a dodgy quad, so was Takahito Mura. He was fantastic. And as you've been saying, Chris, it seems in these World Championships, the judges are looking at your more difficult elements, and if you do them really well, your mark just soars. And he did that.
Yeah, he did. His grade of execution, that's the mark that the judges give for each element, should go up. I mean, the quality, particularly of those two triple axels, was fantastic. Just defies belief. And I was watching that, you know, you almost take it for granted when you sat here watching it. Every jump's a triple. The guys are running on empty at the end of the program, and we're seeing triple after triple, a program full of triples. It is so difficult. They're in the air for less than a second, rotating at, what, nearly 300 revolutions a minute. And you've got to be that exact to stop the rotation. It is quite phenomenal what they're doing.
So easy.
Yes. When it works, it does look easy. Here's that triple axel. Watch this. Left forward outside edge. Drives the leg through quickly into the rotational position. 3.5 revolutions. Spots the landing perfectly. Just to die for. Lovely little change of edge into that loop.
He's probably going to get a personal best. His personal best for free skating is 154 at the end of last year. This season, in the Grand Prix event in Paris. Thought he's going to get better than that here. Best score we've had so far is Hanyu, 169.05, quite rightly so. Fernandez only a mark behind it. And Fernandez holding off Hanyu overall. Where are they going to put Mura? 11th place going in. So he'd be scheduled to be in 5th place. If there's no movement, that's where he'd be.
I think that second mark is going to be key for him. Needs a good program component score.
It's his personal best, 160.72. Is it going to be enough to move him up? It's pretty close. Yep. He does move up at least one. I think it's Amodio who's dropping. And that's good news for Takahito.